What's up, YouTube? Today I have a pretty interesting topic for you guys, or at least I find this pretty interesting. With the iPhone X, I've actually noticed some thermal throttling. Basically, it underpowers the processor or limits the amount of processes being used to keep the heat down. And if you notice, especially on the new iPhone X, it gets very hot, especially right here. Right now I'm running Movie Pro at 4K 60 frames a second. I've been recording for approximately 5 minutes here at 50 megabits a second, and the device is very hot. Now, what prompted me to do this video was I actually noticed in benchmark results the device thermal throttling, which means that it would hold back on process power available. And when this device is really warm, it's actually scoring lower than most of Apple's flagship phones. So why is this important? Well, if you guys are any Apple fans and you remember back in the iPhone 6 days, they actually poked at fun at Android and for the Android processors for thermal throttling very quickly under heavy loads. And if you're a gamer and you bought this device to game and stuff like that, thermal throttling will kick you off. This could be a big issue. Now, I'm going to actually show you guys the thermal throttling, and I'm going to prove that it is actually thermal throttling by cooling the processor as we use it. Right now, the device is very warm. It's pretty hot, actually. It's hot to the touch here. So I want to run a Geek benchmark to show you guys what this device is going to score right now. You can actually even see the device was kind of glitchy there. So now if we run a benchmark, and yeah, I wish I had a sensor to show you guys how hot this actually was. So this was my last benchmark, and I'm gonna show you guys when I run this one. This is gonna take a few moments, and I'm not gonna make you wait through this. I will just skip through it through the video, and we'll get to the end results. And I'll show you guys what I mean. So you can see the frame shuttering already. When the device gets hot, the performance is affected. It's really bad. Wow. So you can see there all the frame drops. This is actually probably one of my best results so far. This is terrible. Alright guys, we're gonna skip through and see what the end results are for this device. So as you can see, the iPhone X did not score very good. It didn't score very good at all. And that's the full test ran. I'm running the latest iOS 11.2 beta 4. And these are the rankings. And as you can see there, put my device under the iPad Pro, under the iPhone 8, under the iPhone 8 Plus. Very close to the iPhone 7 Plus. Now, these are not the scores that the iPhone 10 can hit. The iPhone 10 is actually a very impressive device in speed and power. And in Geekbench, it blows it out of the water. But in this test here, it's a little different. So now I'm gonna do something a little different. I'm gonna cool down the device. So right now it's very warm. And then I'm going to provide extra cooling to the device, and we are going to run this exact same test again, and we are going to see what kind of scores we get. It'd be pretty interesting. So here we go. Alright YouTube, we're going to use some frozen burritos. I don't have the case on the device right now, and the device has been cooling down for a little bit here. We're going to place it right on top of a burrito. Now, just for you guys, if you're wondering, the motherboard or logic board is actually right in this area here, so I am going to focus on trying to get some cooling there. We're going to leave it for another moment or two. Alright guys, so the device is pretty cool now, and we're going to run the same test over again under the same conditions, but the device is going to have extra cooling so that it can perform at its best. You can see the frames are a lot smoother. Unfortunately, the light's hitting it, but I want to leave it sitting there, so we'll just have to deal with the shine. So look at that beastie score we get with the iPhone X now. And that's what you would expect. That's what everybody's been showing. Really high, nice quality scores for the iPhone X. And I do believe this is just a software optimization thing that can be fixed. Hopefully we will see Apple improve on this. I'm quite interested in this. I will be following this a little bit more. Now, I was plugged in the entire time for this video because using these tests drains your battery really fast and I do need to use this device today. I have also performed this test without having a power cable and gotten very similar results. I'm sure there is a little bit more heat produced with the charging, but regardless, you can see the massive score differences. I'd love to see some video responses on this and hear your guys' opinion. So thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you like this video, share it with your friends. How are your new iPhone X performing for you? I'd love to know. This has been really a cool device, just playing around with it. I know that it is first generation and this isn't really to dig at Apple. It's just, you know, I noticed there was something going on and I wanted to see what it was. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you guys again next time.